All right, class, we will start on page 76. What do we have on page 76? Good, these are our A's, the different ways we can make the A sound in English. And our word anyway, it's a two-way word. How do we say it to spell it? Good, we have to say anyway. Anyway. All right, which A do we use in anyway? Right, remember it's, we learned the word way before. And since anyway is a compound word, we're going to use the same A, of course, because we have the word way in it. All right, so we use a two-letter A that we do use at the end of English words. How many syllables are in anyway, class? All right, I hope you're showing me this. There are three syllables in anyway. What's the first syllable? Good, and go ahead and write that. Oh, our second syllable is E, but which E do we use? Good, we use ya, it I-E. So go ahead and write that second syllable, E. And our third syllable is, what's our third syllable? Good way, and you know which A to use for that, so go ahead and finish writing that. Then go back to the beginning and mark it. All right, class, what's our first syllable in anyway? Good, an. Our second syllable? Good, it's E, but which E is it? Good, yeah, I-E. What kind of syllable is the second syllable, class? Good, it's an open syllable. Let's say the rule for our less consistent vowels in an open syllable. So it's I and Y usually say E or I at the end of a syllable, but may say E. All right, and our third syllable? Good, way. And which A do we use? Good, A, two-letter A, that we do use at the end of English words. All right, then we'll start at the beginning. We'll mark this because it's saying its third vowel sound. We'll underline our two-letter phonogram. And then we have, so this is anyway, but remember it's a two-way word. What gets our thinking cap? Good, our A, because it sounds like eh. So we say anyway. To spell it, we say anyway when we're talking. All right, let's put anyway on our next page as well. Because we have an, so we'll put it on our E's page because we have an A in the third syllable, but we also have an E in our second syllable. And which E do we use in anyway for our second syllable? Good, it's ya, I-E. All right, so what's our first syllable? Good, an. Our second syllable? Good, E. And our third syllable? Good, way. And which A do we use in our third syllable? Good, A, two-letter A that we do use at the end of English words. So go ahead and write those syllables. Say the sounds while you write them. All right, remember, anyway is a compound word. So what's my first word? Not just the first syllable, the first word in anyway. Good, it's Annie, and I know that's two syllables. Remember, I always divide my compound word between the syllables. And what's the second word in the compound word anyway? Good, way. And which A do I use? Good, A, two-letter A. That we do use at the end of English words. All right. Gosh, we've got a lot to do in the back of our notebook today because in the word own, let's see, I own two bunnies. Own. Which
O do we use?
Which O do we use in own? Okay, so we're on page 82 and 83. Good, we use ow-o, ow-o. We can't use this. We can't use ah-o-oo with a silent final e job one, or that would be the word one. Remember, like the number? We say own to spell it, but if we wrote it with the silent final e job one, that would be the number one. See, if I use silent final e job one, we know this word and it's the word one. It's not the word own. So we can't use our most common way. We use the next most common O, which is our ow O. All right, so own. Which O do we use in own? Good, ow O. So go ahead and on your next free line for ow O, go ahead and write own. Say the sounds while you write them. All right, class, what did you write to spell own? Good, O. Which O? Good, ow, O. And good, N. All right, and how are we going to mark our ow, O? Good, it's not own. That would be if it was just saying its first sound, so we need to make sure we put the two on top so we know it's own, not own. All right, well, that is it for the back of the book. Let's see. We'll do another video where we put the words in the middle and then write some sentences.